Hello students, now in this video we will see the problem on simplex method. Now let me take type 1, that is unique solution case. In that one also let me take a problem of the type maximization with less equal constants only. Maximization with less equal constants only. Okay, now let me write the example. Example says solve the given LPP using simplex method. So maximize z equal to 40x1 plus 35x2 subject to 2x1 plus 3x2 less equal 60, 4x1 plus 3x2 less equal 96, such that x1 x2 greater equal 0. Now to solve this problem using simplex method, first of all we have to find initial simplex table. To find initial simplex table, we need to find initial basic feasible solution, and that can be obtained using standard form. So first of all, let us convert the given problem into its standard form. Firstly, convert LPP into standard form. This is the first step here. First of all, we will convert it into its standard form. So to get standard form, here two constants and are of less equal type. So here additive variable we need, and that is known as a slack variable. Two slack variables. So we have to take their coefficients as zero in our objective function. So my LPP will become, or the standard form of LPP will be, maximize z equal to 40x1 plus 35x2 plus 0s1 plus 0s2 subject to, here we get 2x1 plus 3x2 plus s1 equal to 60. Then 4x1 plus 3x2 plus s2 equal to 96, such that this x1 x2 s1 s2 are greater equal 0, and these s1 s2 are slack variables. These are slack variables. Okay, now to get initial basic feasible solution, here the IBFS can be obtained. IBFS can be obtained using, or sorry, not using, setting. We have to set. Can be obtained by setting. By setting x1 equal to x2 equal to 0, that is decision variables to 0, and those are known as non-basic variables. These are non-basic. Okay, now by setting them 0, we get, thus that implies here, by setting x1 x2 to 0, we get z is equal to 0 with s1 equal to 60 and S2 equal to 96 from the second constraint. Okay. Now, from these things, we will get initial simplex table. Initial simplex table. And that initial simplex table tells us whether the solution is optimal. If not, we will go for the next table. Okay. Now, let me prepare a table here. Initial simplex table. So here in first column we need CB. Here I will write CB. In second column I will do two parts of it. Here CJ and here B. Let us write it above so that you can easily see it. Let us write it here. We need the standard form to prepare our initial simplex table. Once we write the initial simplex table, no need of the standard form and all. So here, let me write CB. Here it will be CJ and B. In one side I will write B and other side I will write CJ. You know that from, I had already explained that part. Now, here again I need two columns. One is for XB and other is for ratio. Now here I need two rows because there are four variables. Among these, two are non-basic, so two are comes in a basis. Those are basic. So which are the basic variables here? S1 and S2. What are the coefficients of them in objective functions? 0. We will write them here. Here I will write Zj minus Cj. Now, here I have to write the variables x1, x2, s1, s2. We need that, we have to write that many variables which are present in a objective function here. Always remember, for each problem they may be differ. Now, here x1 having the coefficient 40. X2 having the coefficient 35, S1 having the coefficient 0 and S2 also have 0. Now here I will write the coefficients of X1, X2, S1, S2 from the constants, and XB is the right hand side of the same constant. Now here they are 2, 3, 1 and S2 is absent, so 0, 60 respectively. So here I write 2, 3, 1, 0 and 60. Similarly, from next constraint, 4, 3, S1 absent, so 0, 1, 96. So 4, 3, 0, 1, 96. Now, these many things we get. Now here you know, this Z is equal to summation CB XB. Now here, CB is 0 and whatever XB, if we take product of them, we get Z is equal to 0. Clearly the same initial basic feasible solution I have been written here. Look at it. S1 is 60, S2 is 96. Same is here also. Okay. Now, let us check ZJ minus CJ. If ZJ minus CJ all are positive, then it is the optimal solution. If not, it is not an optimal solution. For that we need next table then. Okay. Now let us see to get ZJ minus CJ. Now look at this. ZJ minus CJ is 2 into 0. It's 0 plus 4 into 0 is also, here I have to do this. I will take CB. Let me explain you. Z1 minus C1. So, Z1 will be getting by Z1 is CB transpose into X1 minus C1. So, here it will be CB transpose. What is CB? This one. 0, 0. What is X1? Its transpose we have to take. X1 is this column. 2, 4. Minus C1 is what? 40. Look at this. C1 is 40. So, here its transpose. So, I get 0, 0. It is a row matrix. Column matrix will become row matrix. 2, 4 minus 40. So, it will be, what does it will be? 2 into 0 plus 4 into 0. So, 0 minus 40. So, answer will be minus 40. No need to write it always. For next examples, you can do it directly. So, here I just explain you how does it come. So, 2 into 0, 0 plus 4 into 0, 0 minus this 40. So, here we get minus 40. Similarly, 3 into 0, 0 plus 3 into 0, 0 minus 35. So, I will get minus 35. Now, 1 into 0, 0 plus 0 into 0, 0 minus 0. So, here I get 0. Now, 0 into 0, 0 plus 0 into 1 is 0 minus 0. So, I get 0. Okay. As such, we get Zj minus Cj. Now, not all Zj minus Cj are greater equal 0. So, it is not optimal solution. I must write since all Zj minus Cj are not positive or 0. So, this is therefore the current solution is not optimal. It is not optimal. So, we have to go towards optimal solution. So, for that, we need to obtain pivot element. So, here, to get a pivot element, first of all, get a pivot column. So, now the given LPP is of maximization type. So, the most negative Zj minus Cj represent a pivot element. So, this is most negative Zj minus Cj. So, this is our pivot column. So, among these 2 and 4, one of the element is a pivot element. Now, to get pivot row, let us find ratio. How does the ratio find? XB upon the values from pivot element. Now, 60 upon 2. Here I get 60 upon 2. So, it will be 30. And 96 upon 4. So, it will be 24. So, now the minimum among these ratios is our pivot row. So, this is what minimum here. So, now this is our row and this is our column. So, this is at intersection position. So, this 4 is what? A pivot element. We will do a square to that one. So, here I will write here the squared 4 is pivot element. Here the squared 4 is pivot element which indicates, you know, as this is our pivot column, so x1 wants to enter in a basis and x2 will leave the basis, which indicates that the corresponding column variable that is x1 enters in basis, enters in a basis and corresponding row variable, corresponding row variable S2 leaves the basis. S2 will leave the basis. Therefore, we have following improved table. Let us find the improved table using pivot operations. By using pivot operations. Now, how to find the improved table? Let me tell you. First of all, let me prepare a table. Same columns, same rows are here also. Okay. Same CB here, CJ, B, X1, X2, S1, S2. Now these coefficients doesn't change, they remains same. Okay, XB and ratio. Now here this S1 remains same. S1 and its coefficient is also same, but S2 will leave the basis. S2 leaves the basis while X1 will come at its place, and the coefficient of X1 is what? 40. So those things are changed here. Now ZJ minus CJ. Now how to find the row elements, or here the elements? Now to find the row elements, we will do some operations. So what are the operations? The first thing, we have to make this 4-to-1, means I have to make pivot element, or let me write, make pivot element as 1 1. We have to make this 1 1. So to make this 1 1, we have to divide throughout by 4. So I will divide 4 by 4, it will become 1. 3 divided by 4, so 3 by 4. 0 divided by 4, so 0. 1 divided by 4, so 1 by 4. 96 divided by 4, so XB changes. It will be 24. Now, what about the first row? First of all, we will do changes in pivot element as such. Make it 1, later on go further. Now, to make changes in the above row, what we have to do here, this 2 should change to 0. From this converted row or from this improved row, we will make this 2 as 0. Whatever the other will become, but this 2 we have to make 0. So what I should do? I should do the operation R1 minus 1 upon 2. R1 minus 1 upon 2 R2, right? Or from this one also we can do, or from the improved one also we can do these things. So let me use the same one, R1 minus 1 upon 2 R2. So while doing this transformation, this 2 minus half of 4 will become 0. This 3 minus 3 by 2 will become 3 by 2. Then 1 minus half of 0 will remains 1, and 0 minus half of 1 will be minus half. Then 60 minus half of 96, 60 minus 48, so it will be 12. Okay, so these are our changes. These changes occur in our row. This is our first improve table. Now again find out Zj minus Cj. Here what is Z? This 12 into 0, 0, 24 into 4, 40. So it will be 960. Now Zj minus Cj. If these are again not all 0, we need next table. So Zj minus Cj. What is here? Look at this. 0 into 0 plus 1 into 40 will be 40. 40 minus 40 will be 0. Now always remember, whatever the variable enters, its Zj minus Cj should be 0. If not, you should understand that somewhere you had made a mistake. Okay. Now look at this. 3 by 2 into 0 will be 0 plus 3 by 4 into 40. Look at this. Let me write 3 by 2 into 0 plus 3 by 4 into 40 minus this 35. So it will be, this is 0. What about this? 4 into this is 10. So plus 30 minus 35. So it will be minus 5. So here I will write minus 5. Now, what about this? Look at it. 1 into 0, 0 plus 40 into 0, 0 minus 0. So it will be 0. Now, this is 0 again. 1 minus half into 0, 0. 1 by 4 into 40 will be 10. So it will be 10 minus 0. So here we get 10. Okay. Now, again you can check. Not all Zj minus Cj are greater equal 0, means it is not a optimal solution. So this is most negative here. Now here again we will write same things. Since all Zj minus Cj are not greater equal 0, so current solution is not optimal. Current solution is not optimal. Now, so due to that, we need again improved table. So here I must write again, or let me find again the pivot element and so on. Okay. So what most negative is this, means this x2 wants to enter in a basis. Now 12 divided by 3 by 2. 12 divided by 3 by 2. So it will be 24 by 3. So 8. Again, this is 12 divided by 3 by 2. This element. Okay. So it will be 8. Okay. And 24 divided by 3 by 4. So it will be how much? 24 multiplied by 4 will be 96. So it will be 32. 96 divided by 3 will be 32. Okay. Now, so which one is minimum? Look at this, is minimum here. This ratio is minimum. Means this 3 by 2 is our pivot element. So here I again write here square 3 by 2 is pivot element which indicates that the corresponding column variable, which is the column variable, is that second column, so x2, column variable x2 enters in a basis. enters in basis and corresponding row element or corresponding row variable. What is corresponding row variable? S1. Corresponding row variable S1 leaves the basis. Leaves the basis. Therefore, improved table using pivot operations is what we have to do here. Again, same thing or the similar table. So here again, CB, CJ, B, X1, X2, S1, S2, XB ratio. Again, the coefficients remain same, 40, 35, 0, 0. Now here, this X2 will enter at the place of S1. So here X2, its coefficient is 35. And here already X1 is here and its coefficient is 40. It is already there. Now, again the same things we have to do. We have to make this 3 by 2 as 1. So to make this 3 by 2 1, we have to multiply throughout to this row by 2 by 3. So 0 into 2 by 3 will remain 0. Now 3 by 2 into 2 by 3 will become 1. So this 1 become 2 by 3. Now this minus half into 2 by 3 will become minus 1 by 3. And 1 by 12 into 2 by 3 will become 8. Now we have to make this 3 by 4 as 0. So either use this row or the previous row itself. It is your choice. In both way the answer will be same. Now this by making this to make this element 0, simply we have to multiply by half here. So I can use an operation. What will my operation? Let me write here. R2 minus, we have to make changes in R2. R2 minus 1 by 2 times R1. So 1 minus half times 0. So it will be 1. Now 3 by 4 minus half times 3 by 2. So it will be 0. Now 0 minus half times 1. So it is minus half. Now 1 by 4 minus half times minus half. So minus half will become plus 1 by 4. So 1 by 4 plus 1 by 4 will be, look at it carefully, 1 by 4 minus half times minus half. So it will be 1 by 4 plus 1 by 4. So it will be 2 by 4 and that is equal to half. So here I'll get half. Now what is here? 24, this entry. 24 minus half times this 12. So it will be 6. So 24 minus 6, so I get 18. Okay. As such, you can do the calculation and find out the entries. Now, once we get these things, it is very easy to find Zj minus Cj. Z is what? Summation Cb into Xb. So what is it here? 8 into 35 plus 40 into 18. So 35 into 8 plus 40 into 18 is this the answer for this z. So 35 into 8 will be 8 3 is 24 and 40. So it will be 280 plus this is what 760. So it will be 1000. Okay. So here we get it is 1000. Now let us check zj minus cj. If all are positive, no need to go further. Okay, now positive or zero. Now look at this. 35 into 0, 0 plus 1 into 40 will be 40 minus 40 will be 0. Now 35 into 1 will be 35 plus 40 into 0, 0. So 35 minus 35 will be 0. Now 35 into 2 by 3. So it will be 70 upon 3. 70 upon 3 minus 40 minus half, 40 into half, 35 into 2 by 3 minus, this will become minus, minus 40 into 1 by 2 minus 0. So it will be 70 by 3 minus, this is how much, 20 minus 0 is okay. Now 70 minus 60 upon 3, so it will be 10 by 3. That is what? 10 by 3, positive. Now, next one, next entry, 35 into minus 1 by 3 plus 40 into this half, half. So, minus what? 0. So, this will become minus 35 by 3. Plus 20. So it will be minus 35 plus 60 upon 3. So this difference is 25 by 3. Positive again. 25 by 3. Now you can check all ZJ minus GJ, CJ are what? Positive or 0. So here I can say since all ZJ minus CJ greater equal 0, then current solution is optimal. Current solution is optimal. And what is that optimal solution? Z equal to 1000, or I can say Z max, not Z exactly, it will be maximum value of it. So Z max equal to what? 1000 with what is x1? X1 is equal to 18. This xb represent the solution. X1 is 18 and x2 is equal to how much? X2 is equal to 8. This is our final solution to this problem. So this is one problem I have taken here. Next video I will take more problems. Okay. Thank you.